start the fraud, fraud in relation to the company or body corporate, comma, enough. Something we give to the company in signing, if it is proved that is wrong, enough.
So he is also caught under trap.
You are so specific that most, you are not asking about your directors, your CFO, whether they will be liable.
Because
why you are going to the consultant?
Mens rea. Mens rea is listed with the opinion.
The information, one information I have to say, I am the consultant.
Thank you.
I don't know why he is targeting you.
Sir, I just wanted to ask you whether white-collar crimes are only coming under this fraud, or even blue-collar and other things are also coming in this? Because is it only white-collar crimes?
No, sir. Now, as I explained earlier, there is a collar that is sufficient. They are not going to see any white-collar anything. See, what their idea is, something related to the company is done willfully, then they will be subjected.
Okay, the second question that I wanted to ask is, suppose a company gets amalgamated, and after amalgamation, the transferee company to transferor company, after that a fraud is found, can it be reopened on the merged company?
Yes, absolutely, sir. And see, if the transaction done pursuant to the provisions of the old act, still, as I told you, as for the old act, we can be subjected for the punishment up to 3 years, which we shared. As long as the period of limitation is not expired, whether it is a merged company or a demerged company. In fact, even merged company, if you can see that the transferor company, though it's merged with the transferee company, though it disappeared, that means it dissolved without following the process of the winding up, still the directors and whatever the action done, everything, it won't die with the company. The action is the action, because in fact, rather I should say, the transferor company, though it is not wound up, it is dissolved. That means it is continuing in the form of transferee company. That's the reason they are dissolving, not winding, they are not winding up. What I am trying to say, how the property, how the liability that passes over the new company, same way the crime, penalty, prosecution, that also will pass over. As long as it is proved, it is done with the intent as per the definition.
This provisions relating to fraud is with respect to Companies Act and its rules. But there may be other acts or rules under other acts, it can be environmental laws or consumer laws or tax laws, which have much greater impact on the company's performance. Or if it can affect the shareholders' value, or those frauds are not...
No. Sir, the definition fraud, if you can see, it says in relation to the company, any person under this act only. Something given pursuant to some other act cannot be brought within the purview of the Companies Act.
Okay, no, but if you look at the substance, that damage can be much greater to the...
We can take action, anything done under the provisions of the Companies Act, in a nutshell.
Okay. Only one thing I am reminded from, again I will take you from Thirukkural. யாகாவாராயினும் நாகாக்க சோகாப்பர் சொல்லிழுக்கப்பட்டு காவாக்கால் சோகாப்பர் சொல்லிழுக்கப்பட்டு த புதுக்குறள் ஃப்ரம் தட் இஸ் யாகாவாராயினும் அக்கௌண்ட்ஸ் காக்க காவாக்கால் சோகாப்பர் ஃப்ராடு செய்யப்பட்டு. ஸோ நம்பி கைவை நம்பிக்கை வை, மேபி தட் இன்டெகிரிட்டி அலோன், ஹானஸ்டி அண்ட் இன்டெகிரிட்டி அலோன் கேன் டேக் அஸ் டுகெதர். அதர்வைஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் த சஸ்பீஷன் வில் be there among others. Maybe the intention of the government was a solitary episode of Satyam computers, but whether that incident should trigger this much of calamity in drafting and also targeting corporate and the professionals is a big question mark. But if we together, the corporates and the professionals, follow the ethical method of doing business, the ethical and the honest method of practices, definitely these sections will never turn against. Now let me invite from Vellore, we have a member, partner of B.B. Srinivasan and Associates, a youngster, C.A.B.S. Surya Narayanan, to be here to honor our speaker, C.A.S. Dhanapal, on behalf of Sridhanya Knowledge Care. Thank you, Dhanapal, for that very, very good presentation. Let me invite a member from Kochi, the general manager of Consolidated Shipping Line India Private Limited, Mr. P.V. Verghese. Ah, yes, sir. Mr. P.V. Verghese is the GM Corporate Finance and Accounts. He is from Kochi, Consolidated Shipping Line India Private Limited. Mr. Verghese to our chairman, C.A. Vedanta Ramanuja. Thank you very much, sir. It's a pleasure. Friends, we are going to have two sessions post tea. One is on valuation, where I take adieu from you as a program coordinator. Now I'll be on this side, maybe as a speaker. I want to give my views on valuation, a single chapter, a single section, section 247 on registered valuers. It has a tremendous potential with respect to profession and also with respect to the implications. Now I will go through this particular chapter and this particular section and also the rules and the way at which anuvai thulaithu yel kadalai puguthi appdin solvanga, like that in one particular section they have brought a tremendous potential, and they have recognized a particular field which was not maybe considered as a profession at all, or they have consolidated the profession of valuation together. Now after a cup of tea, let me take you through that particular session with the able guidance of my chairman, my senior in the regional council, CAE Falguna Kumar sir, who is very patiently and very meekly sitting and watching the entire proceedings. We'll be handing the session at the safe hands of Mr. Falguna Kumar post the tea session. Thank you one and all for your patience, sir. We'll be back by 10 minutes.
We'll commence our last technical session for this workshop, the session on registered valuers. I invite the speaker and the chairman of the session, Chairman C.A.E. Falguna Kumar sir and C.A. Gopalakrishna Raju sir, to come on the dais to commence the session. I request Mr. Chandrasekhar, Company Secretary, Hudson Agro Products Limited, to come on the dais and welcome our chairman for the session. Let's welcome our chairman for the session, C.A.E. Falguna Kumar. Thank you, sir. Next, I request Mr. Madhavan, Company Secretary, OPG Group of Companies, to come on the dais and welcome our speaker, C.A. Gopalakrishna Raju, with a shawl and a floral bouquet. Let me introduce the chairman for the session, C.A.E. Falguna Kumar. He has been with us since the morning, and I know he needs no introduction, but nevertheless, to go through the protocol, I'll read out his profile for you. C.A.E. Falguna Kumar is a fellow member of ICAI, practicing since 1979 for the past 34 years as managing partner of E. Falguna Kumar & Co. at Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh. He is aged about 58 years. He is married to Srimati Vijay Lakshmi, who is a doctorate in home science and is working as principal in TTD College. They are blessed with two children, a son and a daughter. Both of them are qualified chartered accountants practicing along with CAE Falgunakumar. In fact, his daughter-in-law is also a practicing chartered accountant, practicing in the same firm. He is a classical flute player also. His educational qualifications are MA, MCOM, MBA, BL, DSA. I think the list just goes on and on and on. He is also a member of the Institute of Company Secretaries of India. He is offering his services to the famous Trust of Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanams as a special auditor for the past 27 years. Their firm is statutory auditors of Amara Raja Batteries Limited, a listed company with 4,000 crores turnover. He is a member of Regional Direct Taxes Advisory Committee. He is appointed as a member of Board of Studies of SV University for the period 2012-14. He has presented more than 140 papers in the past in various CPA seminars in all the four southern states. He has been elected to the SIRC of ICAI in the December 2009 elections. He was chairman of SICASA of SIRC for 2010-11. He was also the treasurer of SIRC of ICAI for 2011-12, chairman of the Taxation Committee and Members Grievance Redressal Committee of SIRC for 2012-13. Currently, he is the chairman of Professional Development Committee. His email ID is also circulated. Any members desirous can reach him at that email ID. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for CAE Falgunakumar. Next, I have on hand a very, very difficult task to introduce CA Gopalakrishna Raju. It is like showing the lamp to the sun. He has been with us for the last 2 days, introducing everybody, all the speakers and chairmen. And now I am feeling extremely humbled to give an introduction to him. Nevertheless, I will read it out for you. CA Gopalakrishna Raju is a practicing chartered accountant from Chennai. He is currently heading the Taxation and Assurance Division of Messrs. K. Gopal Rao and Company, a public accounting firm of chartered accountants from Chennai. He hails from a family of chartered accountants. His father, Shri C.A. K. Gopala Rao, mother, C.A. B. Meera Gopalan, younger brother, C.A. Madan Gopal Narayanan, and his wife, C.A. Rupa Krishna, are all practicing chartered accountants. He got re-elected for the second term to the Southern India Regional Council of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India for the triennial term 2013-16. The various positions he's been holding: Chairman of Direct Taxes Committee, Chairman of Information Technology Committee. Currently, he is the Treasurer of SIRC of ICAI and a Chairman for the Career Counseling Committee. He is also an Associate Member of the Institute of Cost and Works Accountants of India, an Associate Member of the Institute of Company Secretaries of India, Postgraduate Diploma Holder in Operation Research from Pondicherry University, Postgraduate Diploma Holder in Financial Management from Pondicherry University, Qualified Information Systems Auditor from the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Ladies and gentlemen, if I continue reading the profile, I think the next 15 minutes will be eaten up in that itself. So, not to stand before you and the speaker, I would finish with a short profile and I present to you CA Gopalakrishna Raju. I request the chairman to take over and open the session.
Om Namo Venkateshaya. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm good evening to all of you. First, I thank the organizers, Sridhanya Corporate Knowledge Care Limited, for taking a good initiative. In fact, in few towns, a few NPOs organize, say, seminars, lecture meetings like this. In fact, in Tirupati for the past 20 years, immediately after the budget, within a week, a group of industrialists joining with us, we organized a public meeting on to debate on the budget. One speaker from the macroeconomics point of view, one from direct taxes, one from indirect taxes, a public service. So now here on the invitation of Sri Dhanya Hakam, so I thank the company and its directors who have given me this wonderful opportunity. Why is it wonderful? It has got two special effects for me. One, for the first time in my life, I am almost completing 59 years, addressing or say standing before the four different professionals, a conglomeration of CA, CS, ICAA and advocates are here. So together, never I have addressed nor I have shared with them in any meeting. The secondly,